Sunday. Today, I'm going to be starting a weekend emergency medicine vlog. Today, I'm just going to be apartment hunting. I'm just looking at a bunch of places to move into later next month. But I start my shift tomorrow at 2 p.m. So it's going to be taking you guys along for the week. And I will see you guys later. Later. It's Monday morning. It's actually like 11 a.m. Today I have my shift from 2:30 to I think 10 or 10:30. And so before I go, I have a lot of time this morning. So I'm doing some questions from pre-test. My friend Dania, who you saw in some of the other videos, she said that if I do 30 questions a day, I'll be done with the book in like 17 days or something. So she's also doing emergency medicine, so we're doing these questions kind of together. So today I'm doing questions on abdominal pain and pelvic pain. I'm hoping to finish the book maybe halfway into the clerkship so that I can have like the other half of the time to study with other resources. So doing questions now, and we'll head to the hospital in a few hours. Hi everyone, it's Tuesday. Today's my day off, and I am doing a huge like organizing slash donating books and crazy madness. I called the Goodwill and they said they don't accept textbooks, so I have all these textbooks that I'm probably gonna either sell on Amazon or bring it to my school so that somebody can use it. Also trying to really downsize, and I realize I have no idea what to do with all these DVDs. Some classics like Boy Meets World, probably my favorite show. Some of these I'm keeping because they're like my favorites. Mr. Bean, Big Fish, Breakfast at Tiffany's, Manhattan, Virgin Suicides, Life Aquatic, The Royal Tenenbaums, Amelie, Garden State. Also a big fan of Mean Girls and Sex in the City, so I'm keeping these. Although, to be honest, I don't know what I'm going to do with them because, you know, DVD is like a dying technology, and I don't even have a DVD player, and only my old MacBook can play these. And I think last time I tried to play a DVD on my old MacBook, it like wouldn't eject the disc after, or it took a really long time, so it made me kind of nervous. So I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I'm definitely not gonna keep them. I called Goodwill and they said they would take DVD donations, so I'm gonna donate them. Today I'm off, and tomorrow I only have lecture for a couple hours tomorrow, so I should have enough time to get some of the things organized and get donated. So that's what I'm working on today. I don't know if I mentioned, but I found an apartment that I like, so I worked on the application for the apartment. That's what I did last night when I got back, and then this morning also when I got back. So I'm gonna get all my boxes together and head over to Goodwill. I found some CDs, really old CDs that I used to listen to back when CD players were a thing. I no longer have a CD player except for in my car, so I think I'm gonna donate most of these as well. It's crazy all these things that you thought you would use for a really long time, but then they become outdated and then you just have no use for them anymore. Everything's like digitalized and you listen to everything from like Spotify or like iTunes or something. So definitely a weird feeling, but I think I'm ready to part with most of this stuff. So, all right. At some point today, I'm gonna make it to the Goodwill. So we'll see how that goes. So I found my governor school audition recording. I used to play the clarinet, so gov school is like a thing that you can do during the summer. I didn't get it, but I remember recording this at my teacher's house. It was his dad's like recording studio. This is the only recording I have of myself playing the clarinet like ever, I think, in existence. So I'm gonna listen to it and see what I sound like. Alright, my computer didn't play the CD, so I'm gonna try playing it in my car. This is such a weird trip down memory lane right now. I haven't played the clarinet since like 2007 maybe, so this is like 10 years ago. Well, this is actually like 12 years ago because I did it during high school. I stopped playing in college, but wow. Crazy. Anyway, I'm all, I don't know if you can see, but basically like I'm all packed to the brim with all the stuff, so I'm gonna head over to Goodwill and get these things donated. All right, so I just dropped off everything at Goodwill and I'm here at my friend's house. My friend Jane, she's a year below me and she's studying for her step right now. And I have all these third year books that I wanted to give her, so I'm at her house. I'm gonna call her.
Hey, Jamie.
Hey, are you home?
Yeah. Okay. Oh, are you outside? Oh, I see you.
I am. Okay, I'll see you soon.
Okay, I'm coming up.
Okay, bye. I'm doing a quick check-in. I am running to lecture right now. Lecture today starting at 10 o'clock, which is very nice. Today we're talking about trauma, abdominal pain, like OBGYN emergencies, and back pain. So I will see you guys after lecture. Back from lecture, I had lectures from 10 to noon. I had lunch with my friend Dania, and now I'm headed out to drop off checks for my new apartment. Yay! So I'm headed out and probably come back later and maybe film some videos, work on some stuff, and yeah, do all that. Good morning, everyone. It's Thursday today. I have a shift from 9 to 5 o'clock, so a pretty standard shift. I'm gonna be in sort of the less urgent part of the ED. Ironically, it's called urgent care. Basically, it's people who come to the ED but aren't super sick. Usually a lot of people that come with back pain or headache or abdominal pain and their vitals are more or less stable and they can wait to be seen. I guess they don't really wait longer, but they're still seen in a different part of the ED. I like this part because it's like very similar to family medicine and like nothing's like nothing really needs to be done like urgently. So you get to like talk to them a little more and they all stay this like one area and I don't really have to go too far. Yeah, and I get to spend a little more time with my attending because nothing's like super serious. Although you do try to rule out all the super serious life-threatening stuff with these people as well. You should do that with everyone that comes into the ED. So you always think of like, you know, top five, top six, like deadly causes of, you know, different things, different presentations. So that's my shift for today. I'm going to be doing the same thing tomorrow. Tomorrow my shift is, it's the same place, but it's going to be from 7:30 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. So, eating my breakfast, I have my oats here. I like to eat my oats kind of cold, so I just cook it with a little bit of milk and then I add more cold milk. And then I got my coffee here as well. Alright, I'm going to head out in a little bit and I will see you guys later. Hey guys, I'm back. It's 5:35. I have my 8-hour shift today. Today was super exciting because there were a lot of like little procedures and I love procedures. Today we had a guy with like a huge abscess on his back. You can think of abscess as like a really big, disgusting, gross pimple. Basically like a collection of pus like under his skin. So you basically numb it up. You take a scalpel, you cut it open, and you squeeze out all the disgusting pus, and it's like super fun. So I did that today. Also, another lady came in with like a hand laceration. I didn't actually do the stitching because she was a hospital staff, so I think just the attending wanted to do it, so he did that. Did the ultrasound of a gallbladder, try to like get the nice view of the gallbladder with the stones inside, so that was really fun too. Overall, just like cool, fun-filled day. I saw all different kinds of things. And I think that's really one of the things that I like the most about EM, because you don't really have the same kind of patient like over and over again like you would if you were a super specialized internal medicine doctor, like a GI gastroenterologist or cardiologist. You might see like an MI several times a day, or like just coronary artery disease several times a day, AFib, or if you're a GI doctor, you might see like GI bleeds a few times a day. In the end, you really see just like different things like every time somebody comes in. So that's what I really like about emergency medicine. I'm going to try to do my set of questions for today. I think today's chapter is trauma. I already covered trauma during surgery, and also we had that trauma lecture yesterday. So I think the questions should go by really fast. Did I mention I'm watching 13 Reasons Why? It's like about a girl who committed suicide, and she left all these tapes for people to listen to after she died. Really interesting and fun show, so I'm watching that because I have a lot of free time during EM. So that's what I'm gonna do for the rest of the day. Everybody, today is Friday. I have to feed Candy. Hold on 1 second. It's about 4:30. I just got back from my shift today. Today my shift was from 7:30 to 3:30. I think I actually ended up leaving around 3:50. Today I saw a few different things. I saw a guy who broke his finger at work. It was basically like a complete transverse fracture of his like third finger, his like middle finger. He was working. I also saw a guy who had kidney stones. And did I see anybody else? Maybe like one or two. Oh, I saw like a cough. This lady had a cough for 3 months. She came in today. You see a lot of that too. Like, so in the ED, you see a lot of acute cases, so things that need immediate attention. And those are usually, you know, pretty exciting. People coming in with PE or MI or whatever. But then you also see a lot of like non-acute, kind of like family medicine kind of stuff too. So you see a little bit of everything. You get to do a little bit of everything, which is cool. So that was my day today. I'm gonna finish that TV show today, 13 Reasons Why, because I only have like few episodes left, and I'm gonna make dinner, and I think that's it. My days are simple and I like it that way, so I will check in with you guys later. So it's Friday night. I decided to go out instead of staying in. I am going out. Good morning, everyone. It's Saturday. Last night was a lot of fun. It was nice to just go out and have fun with friends. I have the day free, but I have my shift starting at 9 p.m. and then I am working overnight until about 7 a.m. So just gonna be preparing for that. Probably take a couple naps if I can, so I can stay up and maybe get some studying done and really just tidy up the house and find things to donate and things like that. So I'm gonna be closing the vlog here. I think I have a full week of vlogging in this video. And before I sign off, I wanted to thank Audible for sponsoring this video. And Audible, if you guys don't know, offers an incredible number of audiobooks that you can listen to while you're on the go, driving, running errands, whatever. The book that I'm really excited about this week is called Option B by Sheryl Sandberg. Sheryl Sandberg is one of my favorite authors and speakers. I recommended her other book, Lean In, a few months back. And Option B is her new book, and Audible has it, which is awesome, so I can't wait to listen to it. So if you're interested, you can start a free 30-day trial with Audible by going to audible.com/strivetofit. That's audible.com/strivetofit. and you can pick any book you want, and the book is yours to keep whether you continue with the service or not. Hopefully you guys got a good idea of what emergency medicine is like. I'm sure it's very different than some of the other rotations that I've been on. I don't know if I was able to really accurately portray what it's like inside the hospital because I couldn't really film inside the hospital, but basically it's very intense and fast-paced and kind of nonstop when I'm at the hospital, but then when I'm off, you know, I don't really think about what's going on inside the hospital. So it's when you're on, you're on. When you're off, you're definitely off. That's sort of the, I guess, hallmark of being in emergency medicine, and I'm really enjoying my experience. So hopefully you guys got maybe a little bit of sense of what it's like, and hopefully you guys enjoyed the vlog. So I am going to sign off here. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.